μήνες πολιτογραφήθηκε Αμερικανός πολίτης, ενώ δεν σταματά να υψώνει τη φωνή του για τα ανθρώπινα δικαιώματα. Ο Ενές Καντερ Φρίντουμ στο Open Sport. You gave yourself the name Freedom. Would you like to tell us more about that?
The reason I pick that word and made it part of me and carry it everywhere I go is because I know how important the freedom is. And I know how important freedom of religion, freedom of expression, freedom of speech, and freedom of press means. Unfortunately, I don't have any of those freedoms in my home country, Turkey. So I grew up craving freedom. And I also wanted to pick that word because I wanted all the young NBA fans, sport fans out there to research what that word really means. Obviously, Giannis Antetokounmpo and also Milwaukee Bucks is still one of the best teams on Eastern Conference. And they have been playing really good. And I think they are one of the championship contenders. And we are one of the, Boston Celtics is one of the best teams. And it's always a fun matchup for us. I do see them going to Eastern Conference Finals against us. And I hope we can beat them because that will be amazing. But I think Giannis Antetokounmpo and his teammates have been playing unbelievable basketball, and he's definitely one of my favorite players to watch.
In the past, you have not hesitated to criticize NBA idols like LeBron James. Is there anything you would like to add about that?
One of the biggest violations that are happening right now is in China. Not just LeBron James, but many other athletes are scared to say a word because China is paying the bills. There ain't no hiding place
from the Father of Creation. Ο στάρ των Boston Celtics δεν διστάζει να μιλήσει για άλλη μια φορά έξω από τα δόντια για το καθεστώς Ερντογάν στην Τουρκία.
Right after so-called coup attempt, Erdogan fired thousands of judges and replaced them with loyal ones from his close circle. And Turkey never had a fully operative democracy and rule of law, but this recent purge is total collapse. There are so many, you know, human rights violations and political prisoners in Turkey right now. Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. My family had to put a statement out there and saying we are disowning NS. And Turkish government didn't believe that. They sent police to my house in Turkey and they raided the whole house and they took every electronics away. Phones, computers, laptops, iPads, because they wanted to see if I am still in contact with my family or not. And they couldn't see, obviously, any text message or email or missed calls because I wasn't in communication with them. They took my dad in jail for a while. And we put so much pressure from here, America, with politicians and with press, with media to Turkey, they had to let him go. But my family is the only one, you know. There are so many families out there. Their situation is way worse than mine.
You have said that Erdogan regime has been using refugees as a pressure or even threat for Greece and Europe.
Erdogan has been using refugees for a long time. Turkish intelligence has been directing Syrian and Afghan refugees to Greek borders. This creates many humanitarian disasters. This will continue, and no matter what Europe offers to Erdogan, he will always ask for more.
In your opinion, are there any effective means for Greek authorities to react?
Turkish people who are trying to flee to Greece are outspoken critics of Erdogan, and they face with terrible persecution when they push back to Turkey. Unfortunately, we have been witnessing many difficulties recently, most likely because of Turkish intelligence's provocations. Many refugees pushed back on the border. Greece and other countries and international communities must do whatever they can do to create safe havens. I would like to highlight once again Turkish people who are trying to flee to Greece are outspoken critics of Erdogan, and they face with terrible persecution when they push back to Turkey. I think there are incredible friendship stories between Turkish refugees and Greek people, and I hope this will continue to develop.
You have been dedicating victories to the individuals from Turkey fleeing, for example, to Greece. Are you aware of their situation?
I decided to share stories instead of just numbers. Personal stories like mother who has been trying to flee to Greece with her two babies, risking her baby's life to cross the river and find a relief in Greece, and many other stories. I want to use my platform to show the world what is exactly happening there. There are interesting facts. Many Turks whom flee to Greece surprised with the warm welcome and hospitality. Despite the history, reality on the ground is totally different.